as possible. To hold loud in unusual circumstances, make focus and accent. You go first.
Hey, once she gets to go first, please, just be fucking this. The father gets to go first, please be seated.
Your Honor, all my life I've always wanted to be a doctor. And 10 years ago I achieved that goal. And since then we've made so many breakthroughs. We just opened a clinic, and we're planning a new one. And if I'm not around, it's not gonna happen. When the accident happened, I was on my way to an operation. Why should we have two people die instead of one?
Show. It's my large pepperoni. I see. And where do you get these pepperonis? Are they imported? Yes. Although you're very popular on the East Coast, this is your first franchise opened in California. Are you planning on opening any more? Yes. Probably in Valencia. I'm sorry, Papa. We're going to have to cut you off. You seem to be having some technical difficulties. Well, back to you at the station, Connie Kawasaki.
Thank you, Frank. I'm here with Senator Bo Clayton of Dayton, Ohio, here to talk about the new defense budget. There seems to be some sound in the noise in the air, a broken air raid siren or something, but we'll try and continue with the interview. Mr. Clayton, how do you feel about the new proposed budget?
Well, I'm not really into the defense budget, you know. I'm kind of into my own budget. You know what I'm saying? If we only got 74,000 bucks last year, oh, come on, you can do better than that. We'll tax
I'm sorry, Senator. I think we're going to have to cut you short. This noise seems to be interrupting our interview, and it's hard to carry on. Do you have any idea as to what it is, a new defense plan or something?
What, the sound?
Yes.
What? Oh, hey, don't call me.
Thank you, Senator. We don't know what the noise is, but as soon as we find out, we will inform the public. We'd like to get some people on the street reactions to this noise. As soon as we find out, we will inform you. I'd like to say, excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me. Have you been hearing a noise for the past 2 or 3 minutes? Do you have any idea as to what it is, a broken air raid siren or something?
Oh, honey, stop that noise, please.
We don't know what it is. We don't know what the noise is. It's not caused by our microphones. Excuse me, ma'am. Have you been hearing a noise for the past 2 or 3 minutes?
Yes.
Do you know what it is or have any idea as to what it is?
No.
And no, it's not from the mic. It is not from the microphone. It's not from any of our equipment. We don't know what it is. It seems to be in the air someplace. Excuse me, ma'am. Have you been hearing a noise for the past 2 or 3 minutes?
Yeah. You hearing it too?
Yes, it seems to be in the air someplace or something. It's in the air, ma'am. It's a broken air raid siren or something. We don't know what it is.
Wow, how cosmic.
I would like to reiterate, as soon as we find out what the noise is, we will inform the public. But right now, we don't know, so we can't say anything. This is Stephen Vogler at the White House. Back to you, Connie Toyota.
Thank you very much,
Steve.
Back to you, Clay.
Thank you, Connie. Right now, we're going to go to our meteorological expert, see if he has any possible explanations. Dr. Walter Fishwick, we're going to go to a restaurant to see what this possible explanation for this situation might be. Doctor?
Well, boys and girls, I was going to tell you about the recent raids, but I hear this loud noise, and I feel I should tell you something about it, of what I think. It could be some atmospheric disturbance, but we're not really sure. I would say it was in the tide, because we all know everything is affected by the tide. Back to you, Connie Alatino.
Thank you, Connie. Right now, with more on that atmospheric disturbance of this early morning, our science editor, Dr. J. Smith. Dr. Smith?
Well, thank you, Frank. So at noon this morning at 3 a.m., a major meteor shower penetrated Earth's atmosphere. All the meteors burned up the atmosphere, but the meteors contained composed mainly of uranium. Uranium, when mixed with oxygen, formed U-2O6 or uranium trioxide. This uranium trioxide gives off dangerous alpha and gamma radiation, affect the sound pattern of our geosphere. This is only an explanation for the phenomenon, and we have not had sufficient time to decide whether this is true or not. Back to you, Connie Fitzpatrick.
Thank you, Connie. Ladies and gentlemen, I've just attended a special bulletin. Apparently, there's some sort of problem in Washington, D.C. For more on that situation, we're going to go back to our correspondent, Stephen Vogler. Stephen?
The White House is in shambles. A few minutes ago, a special meeting was called because of this noise. They did not know what it was. Many top people were called in, including the president's advisor and a few senators. Tip O'Neill was in the room. A few speculations went around. Invasion from another state, another country, another planet. He heard about the other planet speculation. He climbed to the top of the White House and jumped off. Yes, Tip O'Neill has jumped off the White House roof. We do not know what the noise is, but as soon as we find out, we will inform the public. Please do not be alarmed. It has not hurt anyone. People are just panicking. This is Stephen Vogler at the White House. Back to you, Connie Dawson.
Thank you, Connie.
Thank you, Connie. As Stephen said, we have no more information.
Oh, my God, Frank, did you hear that?
Yeah. Takes us to the White House, gets his name in the paper, our faces
your intelligence has affected your life at school in any way.
No, I don't think so. As far as grades go, I get my grades pretty easily. I don't have to work too hard at them. Most of the time, I just spend with my friends. And my friends really don't care about my test scores. They care about what kind of person I am.
Jane?
Well, mine's okay. I get A's on all my tests. So he's back to school. And I know I'm so
I'm really jealous of you two. It seems like I was meant to work all the time with my studies and nothing on the computer.
Thank you very much, and best of luck for the future. I'd like to thank you all for joining me and joining
lessons. General Smith and General Craig over there. They made their move.
Let's have a nice round of applause for General Smith and Craig.
Now, this week we're gonna ask them how they feel about those moves. Okay, and then we'll give you the finals of those moves. General Smith, how do you feel about your move last week? Putting most of your men in Germany, a few of your men in Lebanon, and a very few of your men in Afghanistan.
I think it was a very good move. I think I surprised and I fortified my captives, and I think it's going to prove beneficial to my side.
Okay, we'll see you in a couple of seconds. But first, we have to see General Craig's reaction. General Craig, how do you feel about your move? Putting most of your men in Afghanistan, a few of your men in Lebanon, and a very few in Germany. Okay. Now, we'll show you how to take. General Smith, that was not a wise move. You lost 51,102 men. And your popularity points are down 37% because of your loss. Your budget points are down 50% because of your loss. You are not doing well. Let's hear a big War Games bomb!
Bomb!
Oh, all right. General Craig, now, this is how you did. General Craig, you're doing very well. You only lost 2,992 men. Your popularity points, although, are down 42%. Because while you were taking over his country, you accidentally bombed two orphanages and three cities containing mostly women and children. But your budget points are up 71%. You're doing very well, General Craig. The next question I have to ask you is, do you think you will need more men?
I think I'll need 2 days, Quinn.
2 days? Do you think you'll need any more?
No, I think that the amount of men I have this time will be quite sufficient, thank you.
Okay. Now, since you need more men, we go to the random draft box! Come on! Okay, now, the first stage is, thank you. The first date is February 4th! February 4th! Does anyone here in our studio audience have a birthday of February 4th? Oh, too bad. Okay, the next date is... the next date? August 12th! August 12th! A very good day! Very good day! Does anyone here have a birthday of August 12th? Okay. Will you please see your national recruiter soon? Very soon, okay. Ha! You can play the game too, ha! Okay, now, General Smith, you do realize that you've already called one-third of your population into the game. Okay, you're going to have to go to the Quick Thinking Guard! Come on down! Excuse me. Come on down, here we go, to the Quick Thinking Guard. Okay, now you know how to play the Quick Thinking Cards. You have three choices and the right answer. Okay, your first choice is the first strike. This is a very daring move. You know that with the first strike, you have two options. You can move your men first, or you can go for the first strike directly. That's a very daring move, and if you do it wrong, your popularity points and your budget points will probably go down. The next choice is surrender. Give up. Give in to the other side. This is another daring move. The third choice, defense. Keep the same defense. You think you have a good defense, keep it. Stay where you are. And then you have the write-in. May I have the write-in card, just in case you decide to write in? Okay, make your choice. We'll give you a few seconds to think about that. Okay, your time's up. What is it?
Taking the
writing. Okay, the writing. The writing says, gas. You want to use gas?
I'm sorry, Squint. According to the Geneva Convention of 1936, gas warfare is illegal. That answer is unacceptable.
I'm sorry, General Smith. You are not allowed to use gas. You're going to have to pick one of the other choices. We'll give you a few more seconds to think about that.
I think I'm going to take first strike.
Oh, the first strike? Oh, we seldom get this, do we? Let's hear some applause for the first strike. Okay, now you know what this means. We're going to have to go over to
The first strike table. Here we go.
Now, this is very rarely played. Very rarely. So, we're going to have to go through the moves with you. Okay, first, you give me the information. I punch it into the computer here. Okay? Now, are you ready for this? This means that this is your last chance. You know that democracy is in jeopardy. Okay, here you go. Feed me the information.
I think I'll move some nuclear submarines to Germany.
Nuclear submarines to Germany. This was a good move, but two of them were found out. The other three will be found out shortly. And also, they've invaded Afghanistan. You don't have a chance in Afghanistan. You have to move out. Go again.
I think I'll move some minor ballistic missiles to the borders of Lebanon.
Minor ballistic missiles.
Yeah. Ready, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4. Next. Resume. Have you been in any Broadway musicals before?
Been there on the roof.
The Sound of Music.
Oklahoma.
Belong to any theater companies?
Royal Shakespearean Theater.
LA TV Quest.
Any unions?
Afra.
Equity.
Dad.
Have you ever sold encyclopedias before?
No, but I can take shorthand.
Can you sing? Can you sing?
Life is a cabaret.
Next. Can you sing?
Oh, I can sing.
She can sing. Can you dance?
Oh, I can dance. I can do anything.
She can dance. Next. Can you sing? Next.
Is it my turn? No, I'm away.
So your sister's?
Yes. Pastor Myrtle, she's from Colorado. And she'll be visiting for a few days. Is that all right?
You know that's against the rules.
Well, I know, but only for a couple days. And I promise we'll get rent in on time.
As long as the rent's in on time. It'll be done.
Okay,
then what?
Well,
make
me sing.
Oh, wow.
Oh, Dad, that's awesome.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
I bet she did great.
Oh, guess what happened to me the other day at the grocery store?
What?
I'm a gorgeous cashier. You went to bring my groceries? A gorgeous green.
What's the wedding?
6 months or 6 weeks?
Next. Ready, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4. Are you on the end? Step forward, please. How many years have you been in the theater?
Well, this is my third year.
30 years. This is experience. Today, we'll be working on improvisational skills. I would like you to form an airplane.
Okay, everybody, let's get that one together.
Do you know this dance?
I do.
Do you know this dance?
I do.
I now pronounce you dancers.
Thank you.
The list will now be posted. The list will now be posted. The list will now be posted.
Thank you. all the way to the left. A third light.
Yeah, last time you said you could.
Excuse me, Greg.
Oh, how you doing, Jim?
Remember what?
The draft.
Okay,
good boy.
249 Dake Street. Or occupants 730. Where's the new guy?
New guy?
What new guy?
We didn't hear about it. You were supposed to bring the new guy from the office today.
Didn't hear about it.
Oh, terroristic. Okay, we'll just try and get started and hope he shows up in time. Okay, we've got a pretty simple situation tonight. We're thinking for a family, the date's coming over to meet the oldest daughter for the first time. I'll give you your assignments now. We're thinking for the mother. She gets pushed around by her husband a little bit, but she's pretty tough, so... You shouldn't have much of a problem with that. You're thinking for the oldest daughter. She's a little worried tonight about her date coming over, you know, meeting mom and dad for the first time. So she's kind of a little going crazy, trying to find 10 things at once. But you still shouldn't have too much of a problem with her. You're thinking for the youngest daughter tonight. Not much else on her mind but TV. It's Friday night. She gets to stay up late. So you've got the easiest assignment tonight. You got on the end, you've got the best one tonight. You're thinking for... Dirk. Okay, Dirk is a laid-off construction worker, and Dirk has had about 6 beers tonight, so you know how he's going to be thinking, all right? Okay, let's get started. It's 7:30, local clock union 248, and... You're thinking for the date that's coming over to meet this family for the first time. I gave you this assignment because it's very easy. He's very in control of himself. He's an athletic type, likes football a lot. Okay. Doesn't have any trouble in this kind of a situation. Stick to your notes and you shouldn't have any trouble at all, alright?
Alright.
You gotta get started now. They'll be coming in any minute. So
okay. And I'd just like to say thank you for this wonderful opportunity,
yeah, thank
sir.
You for the opportunity. We've gotta get started now, okay?
Okay, where should I sit, sir?
How about down there on the end?
Okay. Excuse me. Pardon me. Excuse me. Sir, there's no chair down here, sir.
I know. Okay, let's get started. Local Thought Union 223. It's 7:30. Let's go.
Thank you.
future are.
So, tell me, Ken, what are your plans for the future?
Pre-med at Harvard, sir.
Pre-med at Harvard, sir.
Ah, one of them rich boys, huh? Tell me, Ken, what kind of doctor are you going to be?
Gynecologist, sir.
Gynecologist?
That's not in the notes. Stick to the notes.
I mean optometrist.
I better say something quick. I've had just about enough of this.
Now, Tim, I'm gonna hurry up a bit, huh?
Thank God.
Thank
God. Hey, sugar plum.
Your geeky smoocher is here.
Oh, do I look okay? Oh, dear.
You look great, sweetheart.
Oh, glad to be more. What? Who is this guy? Where'd he come from?
Who's that? Your favorite dog food or I had done here or something. Well, let me tell you about how I got here. Let's see if I
Juanita first.
Don't you like that, neighbor, Pakistan?
this court is now in session. The two parties in concern, please come forward. That's both of you. You look a little confused, rightly so. Both of you were in a collision. Both of you are seriously injured. Only we have a big problem. We don't know which one of you is to die. We are here today in this court of eternity to decide which one will be the doctor. Will the council please come forward and instruct the parties and procedures of this court?
Are you still dying?
One of us is going to die.
I can't die. I have a wife. I have three kids. I'm a doctor. When I had the accident, I was going to an operation. I can't die.
Hey, you're the judge here, right?
Yes, I am.
Well, look, I'm no millionaire, but it's got to be some kind of deal between
you. I really don't think so.
All right. So I made a few mistakes. Beat up a few old ladies, robbed a few liquor stores.
Okay, We just opened a clinic. And we're planning a new one in the future. If I'm not around, it's not going to happen. I'm one of the leaders in that clinic. If I die, it's never going to happen. So many people are going to get hurt. I was on my way to an operation. Why should we have two people die instead of one?
Hey, look, I just got out of jail a couple months ago, you know? I got to get down and straighten out a few things, you know? There is this one thing.
Will both of you two please come forward? In the rather unusual circumstances we have here, both of you will be allowed to make your last statement. You may go first.
What's he get to go first for, huh?
Please, please, have a seat.
Thank you.
Your Honor, all my life I've always wanted to be a doctor. And 10 years ago, I achieved that goal. And since then, we've made so many breakthroughs. We just opened a clinic, and we're planning a new one. If I'm not around, it's never going to happen. I got three kids at home. I got a wife. And she's never going to get to college if I'm not around. I can't. Well, I was on my way to an operation. If I die, the person I was going to operate on is going to die also. Why should we have two people die instead of one?
Thank you very much. We arise and begin.
All right. Look, I'm just as much needed down there as this guy. But without guys like me, who are going to need support than people to make them work a little harder? Sure, we need doctors down there. What good's a doctor if you don't have guys like me hurting the people?
Thank you very much. Will the council please come forward?
What, will you tell them? Will you please tell them?
Hey. Hey, you.
Yeah?
You seem pretty smart, though.
No?
Yeah, you obviously know everything.
No?
Well, let me tell you something. If it wasn't for you, we never would have got into this accident.
If it wasn't for me, I was just driving down the road.
Yeah, that was all your
fault. I saw you. You got in front of me.
You ran right into me.
You got in front. And you were drunk! I saw you drinking out the bottle. You were drunk!
Both of you, please come forward. You seem to have missed the entire point of your last statement. Because that's all it was. It's just your last statement. You see, the decision will not be made. Call it.
Thank you. Well, thank you, Frank. So We're going to go back to our correspondent in Washington, Stephen Vogler, for more on this situation. Stephen?
The White House is in shambles. A few minutes ago, a special meeting was called because of this noise. They thought it was an invasion from outer space, an invasion from another country. The speculation of the invasion from outer space got around. Tip O'Neill heard it. He climbed to the top of the White House. Tip O'Neill has jumped off the White House roof. Yes, Tip O'Neill has just jumped off the White House roof. We do not know what this noise is, but as soon as we find out, we will inform the public. It is not hurting anyone. People are panicking. We don't know what it is, but we will inform you. This is Stephen Vogler at the White House. Back to you, Connie Toyota.
Yeah.
to work. Bye, honey. Gee, your hair smells terrific. That little itch should be telling you something.
Next, but not least, rather, we have Richard.
conscientious pupil. His main interest is computers. Recently, he purchased a home computer and is presently writing a paper on an easier language for home computers. Because of their achievement, all three students have been given the opportunity to talk one-on-one with the president. I'd like to know how all three of you feel about this auspicious occasion.
Well, we all know the percentage of young adults participating in showing their views to the president of the United States is exceedingly low. And I feel that this will give us a chance to voice the opinion of today's high school student.
Are you kidding? No way. It's just the president hears about some kids that, like, want to get into government, right? So he picks some names off the top of a test score and calls us in, gets his name in the paper, our pictures in the paper, and everybody's happy, right? So it's just PR. It's really no big deal.
Well, I think it's really neat.
Do you think that your intelligence has affected your life at school in any way?
No, I don't think so. Most of my work comes pretty easy to me, so I don't have to spend a lot of time in school. And most of my friends, the people that I like to hang around with, really don't care about my brains, my test scores. They care about what kind of person I am. So it's really no big deal.
Well, my intelligence comes easily to me. I get A's on all my tests. They just go bing, bang, boom.
I'm really jealous of you two. I always have to be studying and delivering my books and working on my computer just to try to keep up my grades. And I don't know, I just don't put out much.
Right, so now I'm going to open up the floor to any questions you'd like to ask your students. Do I have any questions? Where? I hear a voice.
Over here.
Ah. Yes, I'd just like to know, do you ever do anything besides schoolwork, or do you always have to study to keep up your grades?
Like I said, I don't have to work too hard on my schoolwork, so I go out on weekends with my friends. We go to parties or out sometimes.
Well, I don't have to work hard at all. It's just easy.
I like to go out on weekends sometimes.
Do you ever do anything without your friends?
No. Well, sometimes I have to get away from the pressure, but that's really very seldom.
Tessa.
Yes, I was wondering, what are your plans for the future?
I plan on going to Harvard and double majoring in computer technology.
Tom, you say that you don't want to go to college. Don't you think you're kind of missing out, you know, wasting your intelligence?
No, because I've been going to school for a long time now, and it's time for me to get out in the world and really experience life instead of just reading about it in books.
But you're supposed to help the world!
What? Hey, nobody said just because I'm intelligent, I've got to go help the world somehow.
I'm sorry, but we're running out of time. But I'd like to ask you one final question. All three of you have exceedingly bright futures ahead of you. But I'd like to know by what or how you'd like to be remembered when you eventually leave this world.
I'd like to be remembered for winning the Nobel Prize in the field of science.
Jane?
I'd like to be remembered as a person who was always there for a friend who never came.
I don't know. I don't think it's that big a deal to be remembered by a whole bunch of people. I guess I'd like my friends to remember me as someone really knew myself.
Thank you, and best of luck for the future. I'd like to thank you all for joining me, and join me again tomorrow when we discuss the tenureship of teachers. Thank you, and goodbye.
street that are smaller than you, you ask them out in person. Not to be done. Now listen to me, when you want a date, you gotta be gentle and nice and sweet to them. You don't go up to a girl named Judy, grab her by the hair and say,
"Sorry."
You're nice, hold on the phone, you bring them a massage, you bring the girl home to the parents. Be real nice, okay? I know. You're not on the first string. You're not on the second string. You're on the third string. And you're not the quarterback. You're a lineman. Now listen to me, you're not a bad guy, and you are a good athlete. Just have that little problem I told you about. Just turn down the volume and you'll be okay. Cool.
We're still all right, aren't we?
We're still all right.
That's what I thought.
Every day, you come up to
Here are our two contestants over there, General Smith and General Craig. Let's have a big round of applause for our two contestants. Now, you remember last week, they made their moves. But now let's see how they did. Now, General Smith, you put most of your men in Germany, a few of your men in Lebanon, and a very few of your men in Afghanistan. How do you feel about this move?
I think it was a very good move. I think I surprised my enemy with my tactics, and I think it's going to prove beneficial to my side.
Okay, we'll see in just a couple of seconds. General Craig, you put your men in the same countries, but most of your men were in Afghanistan. A few of your men were in Lebanon, and the very few were in Germany. How do you feel about this move?
To take the two.
Okay. Now I'll show you how they did on their moves. General Smith, that was a bad move. You lost 51,102 men. Your popularity points are down 37% because of your great losses. And your budget points are down 50% because of your losses. General Smith, you aren't doing well. Let's hear a big war game bomb over here. Okay. Now, General Craig. I'll tell you how you did. Oh, you're doing pretty well. You've knocked out most of his men. You've only lost 2,992 men. But while you were knocking out his countries, you accidentally bombed two orphanages and three cities containing mostly women and children. Let's have a bomb over here. But your budget points are up 71%. Yes, you're getting good funds. Now, I have to ask you the next question. Do you think either of you will need any more men?
Yes, Squint. I think I'll need 2 days.
2 days worth? Okay. What do you think, General Craig?
I think the amount of men I have at this time will be quite sufficient, thank you.
Okay. Since you need 2 days worth, we have to bring out the random draft box. Here we go. Thank you, Carol. The first date is February 4th. Let's hear a big round of applause for February 4th. Does anyone here in our studio audience have a birthday of February 4th? Okay. Now let's see what the next date is. The next date is August 12th. Does anyone here in our studio audience have a birthday of August 12th? Okay. See your national recruiter as soon as possible. Okay. Now, General Smith, you know that you've already used up 2/3 of your population. Calling them into action, you're going to have to go down to the quick thinking card. Come on down, General Smith. Excuse me. Okay, now you know how to play the quick thinking card. Okay. Down here, we have three choices. The first choice. The first strike. This is a very risky move. If you do this, probably your budget points and your popularity points will go down. You have a second choice. Surrender. Give up. Give in to the other side. And then you have the third choice. Defense. You think your men are good where they are. You want to leave them there. And then there's also the writing. May I have the writing card, please? Just in case. Okay. Now, you know how we play this part. We'll give you a few seconds to think about this. Do you need a pen? Okay, which will it be, General Smith?
I'm taking the write-in.
Oh, the write-in. The write-in says, gas. You want to use gas on the other country.
I'm sorry, Squint. According to the Geneva Convention of 1936, gas warfare is illegal. That answer is not acceptable.
I'm sorry, General Smith. Gas warfare is illegal during war. You're going to have to pick another of the three choices. We'll give you a few more seconds. Okay, which will it be, General Smith?
I'll take the first strike.
The first strike! Okay, you know that with the first strike, there is a double option. You may move your men first, or you can go directly to the first strike. Which will it be?
I think I'll move my men first, man.
Okay, that means we have to go to the first strike table! Come on! Okay,
this table, you feed me the information. I have it on a mini computer here. You feed me the numbers and I'll tell you how you're doing, okay? Go.
First, I think I'll send some nuclear submarines to Germany.
Nuclear submarines to Germany. Okay, these submarines were found out. They know that they are in Germany. Afghanistan has been taken also. You did not support Afghanistan well enough. Democracy is threatened. Go.
I think I'll move some ballistic missiles to the borders of Lebanon.
Ballistic missiles to Lebanon. These were found out. They were taken over on the way there. Lebanon is taken too. You have only Germany left. This is your last chance. What will it be?
Squint, I'm going to have to go for the button.
Oh, the button. Ah. Here you go. The button.
Beer.
Beer.
Oh,
my
worse. First, the six months get bigger.
Thank you.
Ready, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4. Next. Resume. Have you been in any Broadway musicals before?
Fiddler on the Roof!
The Sound of Music!
Oklahoma!
Belong to any theater companies?
Royal Shakespearean Theater!
MIT Press!
Any unions?
Altra!
Equity!
Dad!
Have you ever sold encyclopedias before?
No, but I can take shorthand.
Can you sing?
Thank you.
The list will now be posted.